Hey everybody, LuigiFanQuadra1 here once again, and it is time for my plush collection update for 2020. If you want to see what the entire plush collection looked like in 2019, here is a link to the video up there. Anyway, there's a lot of plush to cover, so let's begin. First up is Wispy Woods. This is the Kirby All-Star Collection Wispy Woods. There was a tissue box cover for Wispy Woods initially, but I like this one a lot more. From the Sitting Cuties line, here's Smeargle. Next is the Band Presto Animal Kirby. Here is a Jax Pacific Starly. Pokemon Center Dedenne. Jax Pacific Ralts. Really wanted this one. Band Presto My Pokemon Collection brand Pangoro. Dodrio from the Sitting Cuties line. Sane Metal Mario, as seen in the video up above. Here's Chester Cheetah from Play by Play. Carte Blanche Mini Ben, one of the only pieces of Moshling merchandise I have left. Pokemon Center Purloin. Tiny Jack Specific Chimecho. Sanae All-Star Proto Man. Nanko Carl Weezer. Here is the Snatcher from TheYeti.com. Snatcher's arms are bendable. Kind of. From Jack Specific, welcome back, Pig Knight. Been a long time since you've been on my channel, that's for sure. A Little Walnut Plush. Here is Noctowl. Also from the Sitting Cuties line. From Pokemon Center line, here's Corviknight. Wicked Cool Toys Slackoth. Finally got Pinky. This one is from Toy Factory. Took me a long time to track this one down, but in the end, it was worth it. Pokemon Center Treecko. Here's a Cheep Cheep from Sane / Little Buddy, considering how Little Buddy is the distributors for the Sane plushies in America. Speaking of Little Buddy, here are two Luigis, both from the Luigi's Mansion set. Here is the other Luigi.
Oh no, not again!
Pokemon Center Alcremie. The new type of Waddle Dee plush by Sane / Little Buddy. All-Star Collection, there he is. There were three of them on display, so I took all three because, what the heck? You can never have too many Waddle Dees. Also from Sane, here is Gooey. The tongue is bendable. But if you saw the video up here, you probably already knew that. One of the most recent additions here is Pokemon Center Gallade, with bendable arms, a bendable body, and bendable legs. Jinx-branded Lego Man from Legoland, Steve. A lot of you probably already know this, but the pickaxe is removable. From Sugarloaf, here is Pepe Le Pew. Pokemon Center Toxtricity Amped Form. The arms move, the hands kinda move actually. The legs move, the feet have little pads in them, and the head moves. Huh. From the same line, Sirfetch'd. Very, very handsome. Random Sugarloaf Robot 1. Random Sugarloaf Robot 2. A very rare, very tiny Samurai Mole plush from Sega. Finally got my hands on Solgaleo. This is the Pokemon Center brand. Same with Hangry Mode Morpeko from Sword and Shield. Here's the normal Morpeko, or full belly mode if I'm not mistaken. And here is Corsola. I actually have two of this plush. Here's the other one. I was going to take one and sell the plush, but I figured, we could use more Corsola in all starters, and Corsola is an underrated Pokemon, and you know what? I can't separate these two. Next from the Funko line is Candy Cadet, a plush that I really like, and one of the few FNAF plush I have left. Most of them have been sold away. However, in that regard, I have not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, not six, not seven, but 8 Candy Cadets! You may be asking, why do I have so many Candy Cadets? And I'll tell you, where else is Dr. Eggman gonna get robots? Here's the tiny All-Star Collection Wooloo by Sane. And here is a bigger Wooloo plush from Wicked Cool Toys. I have three of them. Here is Lego Lady from Legoland, I mean Alex, also by Jinx. Also with a removable pickaxe. From Funko, here is Montgomery Gator. You may ask, why do you have another FNAF plush if you got rid of most of them? The answer is simple. I love gators. Gators, Crocs, Caimans, they all good. For the release of Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Rescue Team Deluxe, here is the Pokemon Center Pelipper. Never thought Pelipper would get another plush, but here we are. From the same line, here is Kecleon. Just don't go robbing from his shop or you'll regret it. And finally, here is the purple Kecleon. From my Pokemon collection, here is Tortuga. Another reason why I love the My Pokemon Collection brand, you would never ever get another plush of Tortuga had it not been for them. And this guy was released around Wave 4, so he was released fairly early. Sitting Cuties, Wigglytuff. Pokemon Center Cramorant. Yeah, this guy. From Sugarloaf, here is Porky Pig. Another Bayonet, this one from Tomy. Here is an SNK plush of the one and only Terry Bogard.
Okay!
From Jack Specific, here's Baneri. Welcome back! My Pokemon collection, here is another Ponyard. To go with Wigglytuff, here is Clefable. Also from the Sitting Cuties line. Here is a Square Enix action doll of Sephiroth from Final Fantasy VII. Now with this plush, there's lots of articulation. The arms move, the hands move, you can do poses, the sword is removable from his hand, the head is bendable, the legs are bendable, and he can even stand up on his own. From the Disney store, here is the Evil Emperor Zurg from Toy Story 2. Here is an All-Star Collection Spiny. One of the first plush I got this year was actually from the All-Star Collection. It's Poochie. From Pokemon Center's Pokemon Dolls line, here is Dreepy. From Banpresto, here is Yamask. My Pokemon Collection Dwebble, much smaller than the Banpresto one. Here is Peter Pan from the Disney store. Here is a purple nerd plush to go with the other nerd's plush found in the previous video. Another Shy Guy. Here is Makargo from the Sitting Cuties line. You may notice he doesn't have a tag. This one was given to me as a gift. From Pokemon Center, here is a cuddly Altaria. That's the tag talking, not me. Literally, that's what it says. Still one of the fluffiest plush I own. All-Star Collection Gyarados. Pokemon Center Muna. From Symbiote Studios, here is the Enchantress from Shovel Knight. Much better plush, looks really good. The plush also came with a collectible pin, which I have not removed. From Symbiote Studios and Fangamer, it's Super Meat Boy! Love Super Meat Boy so much. I beat the game, got 100%. It was a pain in the fanny, but it was worth it. Also had to get Bandage Girl too, because you know what? You can't have one without the other, you know? Pokemon Fit / Sitting Cuties Natu. Tiny little bird. And here's Zatu. I actually really like Zatu. I know I said a lot of bad things about Generation 2 in the past, but Zatu is not one of those things. Here is the Hasbro Spoink. And here's another Jack specific Murkrow. Sitting Cuties Farfetch'd. Sitting Cuties Sandslash. Solid party member for any run in red or blue. Pokemon Center Arcanine. World of Nintendo Bob-omb Buddy. From Sané's Pikmin All-Star Collection, here is the Winged Pikmin. Autumn Form Deerling by Jack Specific. Zombie from Jinx, welcome back. Pokemon Center Dreadnought. Tomy Brand Delibird. Hasbro Brand Spinda. Welcome home. Pokemon Center Duraludon. Hopefully I'm saying that name right. World of Nintendo Penguin Mario. In a running position. Here is Minnie Mouse from Disney Parks. basically any Minnie Mouse you find at Disneyland or a Disney store. Jack Specific, Mighty the Armadillo. About time they made a plush of him. Seriously, love how Mighty's getting so much love. Sitting Cutie's Fortress. Another Sneasel from Jack Specific. Another Spike Top from Banpresto. My Pokemon Collection, Cubchoo. TY Squidward Tentacles.
Ha!
One of the rarest plush in my collection, Sandy Cheeks from Mattel. This plush is very old, very rare, but I'm thankful to have it in my collection. Sitting Cutie's Slowbro. Disney Store Professor Z. Maybe asking, why did you get a plush of Professor Z? In due time, I will show you. In due time. Cynosure from my Pokemon collection. Creepypasta Man from Legoland. I mean, Enderman. Also by Jinx. Flop. A little tiny Jack Specific Stunky. Here is Girder from my Pokemon collection.
I have two.
From Sugarloaf, here is Marvin the Martian. This was the first plush I got this year in 2020. An older Disney Store plush, here is the Ace of Hearts. Kirby All-Star Collections, Darouch. My Pokemon Collection, Cottonee.
Sega Baromet.
My Pokemon Collection, Mienfu.
I have two.
Another Gengar, this one by Jack Specific. Cook Kirby by Sane / Little Buddy. My Pokemon Collection, Amoongus. Sane All-Star Collection, Dry Bowser, once again. And as I said there, I really love this blush. My Pokemon Collection, Heatmore.
I have two.
This is the Banpresto brand Floatzel. What a big boy he is. Sitting Cutie's Dugtrio. Sitting Cutie's Pidgey. Pidgeotto. And Pidgeot. What can I say? I love birds. Well, yeah, also Pharaoh. I forgot Pharaoh exists. Yeah. Here is another Snapdragon plush. The first one I got a long time ago, but this one I got this year. Plush made by Jazzwares. Ferroseed from my Pokemon collection. Galarian Weezing from the Pokemon Center. With a very, very tall, fancy hat. Mumbo Jumbo. The original one has been sold away, but this one is brand spankin' new, complete with the tag and the feathers on his head. Zvilius from my Pokemon collection. My Pokemon collection, Cofagrigus. This one has his tag. Here is the Rillaboom plush by Pokemon Center. He is huge. The arms move, the legs move, and he is just very, very big. And now he is doing the splits. Wicked Cool Toys, Sharpedo. Look at them fangs. It's Cinderace from the Pokemon Center, with movable arms and movable legs. Similar to Rillaboom, she is tall. Mario All-Star Collection, Baby Peach. Mario All-Star Collection, Baby Daisy. And Mario All-Star Collection, Baby Rosalina. From Puyo Puyo, here is Dragon, also from Sega. Here is Togedemaru from the Pokemon Center. Very, very round. Not as round as Voltorb, but still very round. I can still roll him like this. Sitting Cutie's Togetic. Jinx, Cave Spider. Kid Robot, Coco Bandicoot. Two teeny tiny Banpresto Goomba keychains. Autumn Saucebuck. Spring Saucebuck. Summer Saucebuck. And Winter Saucebuck. From Sega, here is a tiny Arl keychain. Fangamer Bomberman. The bomb has little magnets inside of it. Here is the plush itself. The legs move, the arms move, the head kinda moves, and funnily enough, the eyebrows are magnets. Prepare to meet Mr. Angry Eyes! Pokemon Center Sentret. My Pokemon Center Vanillish. My Pokemon Collection Zoroark. My Pokemon Collection Swanna.
I have two.
My Pokemon Collection Darumaka. Here is Toad from Sane's Mario Party 5 collection from 2003. My Pokemon Collection Volibee. Seal from the Sitting Cuties line.
I have two.
Snover from Pokemon Center, back in 2007 actually, so this one is pretty old. Cryogonal from my Pokemon collection.
Another Sega Prize plush, here is Panty.
Pokemon Center Chandelure, my favorite Chandelure out of any Chandelure plush I own. This one is amazing. Sitting Cuties Cloyster. My Pokemon Collection Electric.
A Stormtrooper by Comic Images.
Here is a Boo plush from the Super Mario line, but interestingly enough, the tag says World of Nintendo. Makes me think they took all the Boo plush from that line and they've re-released it alongside with the Goombas, the Bullet Bills, and the Mario and Luigi's. Or we could be getting new Mario plush with the Super Mario brand.
Mario All-Star Collection Boo.
I have four of them, but for some reason this one's tag is bigger than the others and I'm not sure why.
Sega Prize Stocking Anarchy.
Sega Prize Garter Belt.
My Pokemon Collection Bisharp. Pokemon Center Poltegeist. How can you not love this little guy? His name is Poltegeist. Does the name alone want you to get this Pokemon on your team? His name is Poltegeist! Here's LGM, from my Pokemon collection. Finally, Pokemon Center Curlia. I've been looking for this plush for a long, long time, and I finally got my hands on this plush. Vanpresto Pika Libre. From Heartland, a Tomy group, here is Ruben.
Here is a My Pokemon Collection Tynamo.
I have two.
Banpresto Star.
Banpresto Mushroom.
Another Banpresto Mushroom.
A Banpresto Mini Mushroom. Probably the tiniest plush I have. Half the size of my pinky. That's how small we're talking about.
SK Japan's Sailor Waddledee. This was released for Kirby's 25th anniversary for the Bon Voyage set. Sitting Cuties Houndour. Fairly recent plush, Great Eastern Entertainment Infinite. Not even removed from the package. Until now. Regarding official plush, Infinite 1, Zavok 0. Here is a Takara Tomy ducklet. Welcome back. And here is a My Pokemon Collection ducklet. Sitting Cuties Graveler. With a cute face only a mother could love. My Pokemon Collection Krokorok. The King of the Internet, I mean Snom. Also from Pokemon Center. Kirby All-Star Collection King DDD. Mario All-Star Collection Shy Guy.
I have four.
Fangamer Octodad. All-Star Collection Nightmare Fuel, I mean Garchomp.
Sega Prize Brief.
My Pokemon Collection Simisage.
I have two.
Jack Specific Wooper.
Banpresto Zoroark.
Banpresto Staraptor. Pokemon Center Phalanx. Pokemon Center Inteleon. He is very, very tall. His body moves, his arms move, his tail moves, and his legs move. When it comes to articulated plush, a vast improvement over Incineroar, that's for sure. Since he bends in his tail and in his arms and legs. Mario All-Star Collection Goomba.
I have six.
My Pokemon Collection Durant. Another god of sorts, here is Furret from Pokemon Center. For articulation, Ferret's whole body can bend, but not the feet.
Here is another Banpresto Goomba with sound. This one has its tag, and it looks much better than the other one, which was very, very old. Here's the founder of the Big Brain Academy, I mean Calyrex. Interestingly enough, the arms are bendable, the legs are very bendable,
and the body is kind of bendable, but not really. And surprisingly, his noggin is actually kind of bendable, which is pretty cool. Jack Specific Wingle.
I have two.
Here is copper number one. This is the used condition copper, as you can tell because his pole is chipped. And here is Booker one, made by Sane, also in used condition.
And here are the same plush, but with their tags and in practically mint condition. One thing I don't like about these plush are the gloves and the shoes, because they're made out of this weird paint-type fabric.
And the paint-type fabric loses its luster over the years due to age, so I have to keep them in a very safe place. And even though that may be the case, copper already has signs of wear, even though I've kept them in storage. Because these plush are from 2005. Here's a Chinchino from Takara Tomy. Very hard to find nowadays, I'll tell you that much. At last we have a trainer. Here is Red from the Pokemon Center. Specifically from the Pokemon Trainer line. Kirby All-Star Collection Scarfy.
I have three of them.
Here is UFO Kirby from SK Japan.
My favorite ability.
Here is Captain Toad. This was the last plush I got in 2020. Also by Sane / Little Buddy. Mario All-Star Collection Hammer Bro.
I have two.
And here is the original Hammer Bro.
Again, I have two.
Here is Bursa by Linkson. Here's Captain Deadbeard. It says the plush was made by PopCap, but I don't know about this one. Clang from my Pokemon collection.
Again, I have two.
An original Sane Waddledee.
Who ordered the cop?
Oh, right!
Here are two plush that are pass holder exclusive from the Haunted Mansion set. This is the butler. And here is the maid. I absolutely adore the detail on these plush. Last but not least, from the Pokemon Center, here is Dragapult! The very minute he was on the Pokemon Center's website, he went out of stock. So, yeah, just goes to show how popular he is. He is hands down my favorite Pokemon from Generation 8, and I am more than happy to have him in my collection. Now for the customs, starting with Milk Cookie from Cookie Run. Arms are bendable, weapons are removable, and the legs do not move. Here's Sheik. Here is a new and improved Baron Von Batz, as you can see here. The arms are bendable, the hat is removable, and so is the scepter. Here's Commander Tartar. For some reason, his pole is bendable. In case he wants to sit, for some reason, like, I don't know.
Here is Solid Snake. We tried to give him a butt, because why the heck did they remove Snake's butt in Ultimate, yet Bayonetta and Sheik get to keep theirs? It makes no sense!
Anyway, the arms are movable and bendable,
so you can make him sneak around.
Although there's only one queen, and that's Zelda. Here is Young Link. Here is Young Link's shield. Here is a pseudo-custom. This is Mr. L. What we did was we took an official Luigi and we made clothes for him. However, these clothes are permanently stitched onto the plush. Here's Mabel from Gravity Falls. Purple Yam Cookie from Cookie Run.
In the case of Purple Yam, the arms are bendable.
Here's Corset, easily one of the most underrated villains of all time. Yeah, sad. You're the main villain of your own series, yet you get thrown under the bus and you have barely any fan art. Shame. Here is Richter Belmont. Here is Seashroom. Another pseudo plush. Here is Bandanity. From the game Nefarious, here is Princess Tephra. Tephra was actually a backer reward, and I said, hey, I think Tephra is a pretty cool character, so why don't we get her as a plush? And the creator said, sure. So here we are now.
Here is Dustman from Mega Man 4. my favorite robot master of all time. One cool thing about this plush is you can put stuff inside of his head, and then launch it, like so. Here is Popo, and here is Nana. Both ice climbers have removable mallets, and they have bendable arms. Here is Zero Suit Samus. Here is Justice from Helltaker, one of my favorite games from this year. Her jacket is removable, her arms are bendable, and you can lift up her shades. Last pseudo-custom is Army Hammer Bro from Super Princess Peach. Probably one of the most underrated Mario games of all time. And in case anyone's wondering, Army Hammer Brother is the inspiration for Chief Hammer Bro in my show. Actually, they're the same character, just with a different name. Here is Min Min, one of the most difficult plush to make. Not sure if you can tell why. Anyway, the arms are indeed bendable. The bottom part of the dragon's mouth is also bendable, and so are the little antennae on his head. Last but not least, all that they say and do is right. Here are the Moonanites. This is Ignignacht, and here is Ur. No one can defeat the quad laser.
So, these are my plush that I'm going to add to the plush collection, specifically from the year of 2020. Now, I know I always get the questions like, where do you get them? As always, the answer is eBay. Another question always being, can I have them? The other answer is no. The long answer being, there are many different ways to find your own plush. Just keep looking. Again, eBay's a big one. Mercari is another big one that I found. Really good, although not nearly as good as eBay because it has less options available. For the Pokemon, I know Pokemon Center is a really good choice, especially for ones like Pharaoh, as you just saw there. For customs, those can be found on Etsy, and there are several people online who are more than happy to offer you a commission. Amazon can be okay for some plush, but I highly recommend being aware of what you purchase because several plush on there are fake. On eBay, there can be fakes too, but it's easy to tell the difference between a fake plush and a real one.
Even though 2020 itself was definitely a hectic and crazy year, I'm hoping that there were a few positives in your year that made it a little bit better, you know? So I want to hear it from you. What did you find to be good in 2020? For me personally, I'm thankful for all the new friends I've made, been able to help out my family, and I've been improving upon my cooking, actually. No thanks to Chef Biggie, I'm sure. Anyway, some plush can actually be bought from retailers.
If you're looking for actual retailers, I recommend either Hot Topic, Target, or Walmart, or even Barnes & Noble, to be honest. Barnes & Noble has a really good selection of Mario plush. I know Captain Toad is one of the ones I got from Barnes & Noble. Well, I'm not only out of things to say, but we've reached the end of the horde, as you can see here. So until next time, this is LuigiFanQuadra1 signing out, saying see you later, stay safe, and have yourselves a fantastic new year.